Israel's biggest city has come under sustained attack, with Hamas, Hezbollah and Yemen all firing rockets or missiles at Tel Aviv. It comes as Hamas provided a rare update about the condition of hostages, releasing a propaganda video saying the remaining captives are surrounded by danger. 10's Europe correspondent John Paul Gonzo reports from Israel.
Throughout the day and into the night, Tel Aviv was targeted. Rockets and missiles overhead sent people running for cover. Almost all were intercepted, but some made it through the projectiles launched by Yemen, Hezbollah and Hamas.
Despite Israel's relentless strikes on Gaza, Hamas fighters have been able to regroup. The attacks on Tel Aviv, another sign of the terror group's resistance after a year of war.
Around 100 hostages remain in the Palestinian territory, including Ricardo Grichner's 22-year-old nephew, Omar.
We are in the worst situation that we've ever been in the last 12 months.
Momentum for a hostage release deal appears to have slowed, with the Israeli government pushing ahead with the ground offensive in Lebanon. The operation there now includes coastal areas. Evacuations have been ordered in beachside towns as more IDF troops enter the country. As long as the enemy threatens our existence and the peace of our country, we will continue to fight, Benjamin Netanyahu says. But an increasing number of Israelis want to know what the end game is.
We need to start speaking about real solutions, not lip service, not be complicit with what politicians say. And until this is done, we will keep seeing violence, dead people, Gazans who are extremely suffering, and Israelis that want their lives back.
Udi Goren's cousin was murdered by Hamas in a cruel twist. His body is still being held by the terror group. His grieving family just want to bury him with dignity.
It's about giving us the chance to have some closure, end this period in life that is just continuous, ongoing, crunching trauma.
That grief is felt by so many, not only in Israel, but in Gaza and now Lebanon too. John Paul Gonzo for 10 News First, Tel Aviv.